Good afternoon, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure to extend you very warm welcome on the behalf of Department of Computer Science in Tirthangal Nodar College, who has clubbed all of us for the national webinar on cyber hygiene in times of pandemic and post-pandemic. Now I request to call upon our head of department, Dr. P.T. Kasturi Boy, to provide warm welcome address of the event.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. This is Dr. P.T. Kasturi Boy, Head Department of Computer Science, welcoming you all for this national webinar on the topic Cyber Hygiene in Times of Pandemic and Post-Pandemic. It's my pleasure to invite our Honorable Secretary and Correspondent through MGE Chellaparam Sir, respected Principal in Charge Dr. K.C. Lalitandiga Ma'am, Vice Principal Professor Asi Tambi Sir, for their continuous support and encouragement for conducting such type of events. It's my pleasure in inviting our Chief Guest Dr. R. Deepalakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Application, the Tamil Nadu Dr. Ambedkar Law University, Chennai, for accepting our invitation. I welcome you, ma'am. I also welcome the heads of various departments, faculties, faculty members of this institution. I also welcome the participants, the student delegates, faculty delegates from various city colleges to enrich their knowledge. I once again welcome you all for this wonderful national webinar.
Now I request our principal in charge, Dr. K.C. Lalitandiga Ma'am, to introduce the resource person.
Thank you, Mrs. Divya. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the national webinar on cyber hygiene in times of pandemic and post-pandemic, organized by the Department of Computer Science. I take this opportunity to introduce a resource person, Dr. R. Deepalakshmi, Assistant Professor of Computer Applications, Tamil Nadu, Dr. Ambedkar Law University, Chennai, to this virtual platform to address our students on the pertinent topic, cyber hygiene, which refers to cyber security best practices that an organization's security practitioners and users can undertake. Regarding her academic career, she has worked as a head of the Department of Computer Science and Applications in Sir Tyagaraya College, and she has over 16 years of teaching experience and more than 10 years of research experience in the field of data mining, algorithm analysis, geographical data mining, bioinformatics, image mining, and cybercrime. Dr. R. Deepalakshmi received her MCA degree with distinction from Ethiraj College for Women and received her MPhil degree from Madurai Kamaraj University. She completed her doctorate degree from the University of Madras. Our resource person, Dr. R. Deepalakshmi, has published more than 20 research articles in the national and international journals with high impact factors and in Scopus Index journals too. She has presented many papers and conferences and received many awards. Yes, and received many awards in academics and research. To name a few, Research Excellence Awards in 2019 and Young Researcher Award in 2018, Best Teacher Award in 2017, and Young Women Educator and Scholar Award in 2020. In addition to this, she has also received many, titles and appreciations from various universities. Dr. R. Deepalakshmi, Assistant Professor, has authored more than 5 books in her discipline. Being a coordinator for many international conferences, seminars, and workshops, she is an active resource person in many colleges. Dr. Deepalakshmi has guided many MPhil research scholars and has produced the best candidate in her area of specialization. She is a woman of passion who is interested in latest technologies. At present, she is handling WebEx teaching technology in Tamil Nadu, Dr. Ambedkar Law University. It's an honor and a privilege for us to have you with us today, ma'am, to address our students. I'm sure our students will surely be enriched by the rich inputs offered in this session. Once again, I welcome all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. So as to know more about the cyber hygiene during pandemic periods, we would like to call our chief guest, Dr. R. Deepa Lakshmi, ma'am, to share her knowledge.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Principal Dr. Lalita Ambigai, ma'am, head of the department, Kasturibai, ma'am, and all the faculties of Tiruthangal Nadar College for giving me a very brief introduction. Thank you very much. So let's move on to today's topic. The most, I can say, it's a need for the hour, right? Cyber hygiene in times of pandemic and post-pandemic. So to start with, in pandemic for last year, for 2 months, we are in the position how to educate our children, how to continue with our studies, right? Because we are in the phase of face-to-face learning. So how to continue and how the students will take over it. So definitely I can say, like, without the help of these IT technologies and computers and mobile phones, the students cannot be passed over from second year to third year or first year to second year. So when every education, all the education are possessed only through these IT technologies. So how important is cyber hygiene? So because most of the students, not say computer science students might be using, but most of the other branch of students are prone to use these types of laptops and mobile phones only during this pandemic period. So it is very important how we must be safe to use our devices. So that is what I think it's a need for the hour, how we have handled during pandemic and also in post-pandemic, how important is the cyber hygiene. So let's move on to the topic. I once again thank Dr. Kasturibai, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity, for inviting me as a resource person. Thank you very much, ma'am. So let's see the agendas of today's. First, talking about cyber hygiene, definitely I have to talk about data and information because we are going to keep our data and information safe. So we will be inculcating what is information security and how the information is stolen. What is information theft? What is information security issues? What are the best security practices and tips for information security? What are the common mistakes? Even the known and unknown persons, what are the common mistakes they are making? Information security and cybercrime, and how it is related to IPR, digital and electronic signature, mobile security, data loss and recovery, and how we can handle all these. So moving on. So I'll be just practically handling this session, not going into too much of theoretical, because I think computer science students are well aware of theoretical portion. So just an overview of how to be secure in this pandemic period, as now even most of the classes are online, and even moving forward, definitely it will be a blended mode of learning, like 50% offline and 50% online. So how we have to be safe in this pandemic period. Okay. So what is information security? So the other name for information, I can take it as data, right? So data is available everywhere. What is the most necessary part? The data must be secure. We cannot give all the information to everyone, those we know. So we have to keep the data or keep the information in most secured form. So how we can keep it and how to handle the data? That is most important, right? So the practice of protecting systems, networks, and programs from digital attacks. We will be seeing in the later slide what are digital attacks. Yes. So when I am talking about data and information, it is not just data or information, it's your personal thing, correct? You are going to give your date of birth, you are going to give your residential address, you are going to give your name, to whom you are giving it. First, that must be noted. So since you must not treat that as a data for just entering into your Facebook or entering into your Google, it is your personal information, and only if it is an authenticated website, you have to give your information or data. That is the most important thing you have to take care of. And not only for the students, even you have to, students being a students, you have to inculcate to your parents and your neighbors, because everything is online. We will be doing online shopping. What your parents will know, like if you enter, if you pay the amount and everything comes into the home, that is enough. It's not important like whether their card is saved or the card information is saved in the system. They won't be worried about that. So you have to educate your neighbors and teachers about, parents about how the information is more important. Yes. So speaking on to the seventh principle. So what is the seventh principle in information technology? That is the security of personal data. Because the appropriate technical and organizational measures can be taken against unauthorized processing of personal data. So it is a cyber crime. When your data is taken by an unauthorized person and is using without your knowledge, definitely it is going to be a cyber crime. So we have to be very careful in that. Because whatever data we are now using, it is stored in cloud. It is easily accessible by everyone without your proper permission. Okay, so what are the best practices? The first best practice I can tell to anyone is use the principle BIOD. What is BIOD? Bring your own devices. Don't trust on any device. Don't trust on any public device. If you are going to use your internet, bring your own device. Either it may be your tab or your mobile phones or your computer systems or your laptop, anything, bring your own devices and use your own devices. Okay, so, and also I can tell one more thing, don't use Wi-Fi in railway stations or bus stands because it can be easily stolen. The cyber theft is mainly done in the public places, common Wi-Fi. Don't ever use the common Wi-Fi until or unless it is most important and there is no other means for you. Okay, use your mobile data, use your hotspot or anything else, but don't go for the common Wi-Fi. Okay. So encryption. So you all know what is encryption, right? Because transferring from one text to another by means of ciphertext. The ciphertext is again converted to the plain text. So we can use the methodology of encryption for protecting your data. Madam, for my father and mother, how can I teach what is encryption? So you are having your bank account number or bank ATM password. And if anyone have the practice of writing everything in your diary, okay, instead of writing it as 1, 2, 3, 4, why can't you just transfer and write it as ABCD? That is all a practical encryption technique we can use. Use a code which can be understood only by you and not by anyone else. Okay, that is a practical implementation of encryption. So whatever you write, a personal, that is very delicate information, try to encrypt the data and write so that even when anyone steals your diary, no matter, it is not going to be, your data is not stolen, right? So use the technique of encryption whenever it is more important. Yes. What's on your website? So online shopping, for the last 1 year, everyone is into the online shopping. Even those who are not very well versed in online shopping also, they are prone to online shopping because no other shops are open. Okay, so what they are going to do, they are going to take their credit card, how many credit card, they are just saving the number and the credit card and saving all the details. What is the purpose of saving all the details? Because next time I don't want to enter my credit card number. That is the main thing, right? Just I am saving the details. So the next time when I log into the thing, it will automatically ask, yes, this is the card number. Okay, yes, press enter. So you are giving way to the hacker to steal your CVV, to steal your a CVV number, card number, personal information, etc., your bank account number. So everything can be known by the hacker. So you have to be very careful. So don't save any credit card number in your phone or your laptop devices. Okay. So as I tell, now I am just speaking about somebody is going to hack, somebody is going to steal your information. So these are called as hackers. Computer science students will be known well about that. Yes, these are known as hackers. So hackers, we are having many categorization of hackers like black hat, gray hat, white hat, etc. So over Tamil, over example, solvana, ஒரு வீட்டோட பூட்டை வந்து அந்த ஓனர் உடைக்கிறது வந்து யூ கால் இட் அஸ் அ ஒயிட் ஹேட் பிகாஸ் இஸ் அத்தாரிட்டேட்டிவ் பர்சன் டு பிரேக் தட் லாக் ரைட் But someone other than the owner is going to enter into the, going to break the lock, he is called as a black attacker. Okay, so the thief who tries to enter into your personal information, who tries to steal your information, you call it as a black cat. But the person who is trying to enter authoritatively, you call it as a white attacker. So this is what the hacking will be done, because every data is stored as a digital information. So it is easy for the hacker to steal. So don't give way for him to encrypt your information. Okay. So now we have thought about, like we have spoken about, what is data, what is information, what are hackers, how we have to be secure. So now we are the next step. What is online security? How can we save ourselves from the hacker? So this online security is a issue of global concern. It's not only within the, whether it is a housewife or a student or IT. No, everywhere it is a global concern. Even the person who knows very well about this online concept also makes some mistakes. Yes, mistakes are made by human. It is very common. So not only for corporators, but also for your home users, education or entertainment, it is the online security is not up to the mark. So we have to be careful while using emails, Google, antivirus, MS Windows, etc. So emails, whenever we have a mail to our, we just start clicking the mail and just open it and read it. Please don't ever do that. Unless or otherwise, your contact is verified contact, right? You have to see the contact. If it is a verified contact, you just open it and you can read it. If it is from your friend who is known to you, whose email ID is known to you, or if it is from a bank, yes, bank has a separate website or a separate mail ID, and you know that bank mail ID, okay, you can open. Otherwise, if it is from any other untrustable mails, please don't ever open, because it may be a spoofed message, okay? So information security is very important. We cannot stop using internet, right? If internet is not there, there is no national webinar is there. There is no online classes. So everybody is going to be there. The first year students will be there in the first years. The third year students will be there in the third years. Only with the help of internet, the students are getting promoted, right? That is the very great advantage of this online classes. So be aware of how cyber criminals work. We have to use the concept of digital locker, because the Digital India is based on the concept of digital locker. So we can use all these things. So the next thing is about threats. So I think everyone will be known about it. I'm not going to go in detail because it is going to be a theoretical concept. So I want to just give you information and just how to come out of all these. Okay, so we know what are all the different types of threats which are available, like ransomware, malware, worm, trojan, spyware. So these are all the threats you would have read in your, I think so, third semester or second semester. So these are all the malicious software. So how we can protect from these malicious software, right? There is a concept called antivirus security. So how many of you have, you can ask yourself, right? You can ask yourself, do I have antivirus in my mobile phones? Do I have antivirus in my laptop? Do I have antivirus in my desktop? I think 50% of the students or even teachers will say no, because we are least bothered about that, right? Because at that time, we need some information. At that time, we need to use the laptop. At that time, we need to use our mobile phones. We are not bothered about whether that system is protected or not. What we are doing, we are keeping our jewels in the locker. We are keeping our money in a wallet. And that wallet is being protected and it is not going from us without, we will not keep our wallet in the table and go anywhere. But we will be keeping our laptop here and going anywhere. Yes, that is not the thing we have to do. Okay, what are the 10 most dangerous? There are many dangerous information security issues, but I will be listing just 10 most dangerous information security issues, which I feel it is more important. Okay, that is invasion of privacy. The private details will be stolen. And the second one is completely anonymous on the internet. That is, you can download, there are free downloadable softwares like TOR. Okay, so it will not allow all the web pages to enter into your computer. It will be bounced from the internet connection. So you can use that and your IP address will be hidden and your location will be hidden. Clear? Because the hacker or the main point, when your IP address is known to him, it is easy for him to steal your information. So these types of software is supportable for you, so that the IP address will be hidden, the identity will be hidden, the location will be hidden. So why can't we use all this? there are more things, more apps are there available. The next one is spoofing. I think you know what is spoofing, but I want to tell you, like, there are something like email spoofing, because see, I have come across some sort of website like smsgang.com. I got a message, you can send hundred rupees for a spoofed message. That means for an unauthenticated message. So anyone, if anyone is going to get 1 lakh out of that, spending 100 rupees is nowhere to him, right? So there are websites which promotes these type of illegal attempts. So we have to be very careful. Next, we can move on to hack into the mobile phone spy. Yes. I can tell, like, 75% of the users, that is online users, will have antivirus in your laptops or your PC. But definitely, I can say that 75% will not have in their mobile phones. Because the only thing I can say is, laptop cost around more than 50,000, but our mobile cost only 10,000. No, it is not like that. Data is data. Whether it is available in our laptop or desktop or mobile phones, data is data. So we have to be very careful to protect our data. So even in your mobile phone, you have to install an app like antivirus security, etc. One thing is like that, if you're keeping your mobile phone unattended for just a few minutes, say you're going to some restroom and coming inside, okay, a victim is there, maybe your friend also, okay, we don't know whether we think that he or she may be our friend, but he may be a victim of yours, right? So he may take your phone and install an app so that he will be knowing to whom you are talking, to where you are going, the Google map, everything will be accessed by him. So don't leave your mobile phone or laptop unattended. That is the main thing I'm telling. You're not going to leave the jewels and go anywhere. You're going to put it in a locker. You're carrying your wallet everywhere, wherever you go. So the same thing, wherever you go, carry your laptop, carry your mobile phones, unless or otherwise you're locking the room and going it. Okay. So secure communication. Wizard, Telegram, Red Phone, these are all freely available confidential message tools. So the communication will be secured and it cannot be hacked by anyone. Next is cyber terrorism. Yes, they are mostly using this. Hackers are 20 to 25%, I can say, there are cyber terrorists. Okay. Even in 2001, Al-Qaeda attack, they used a concept called steganography. Next is your phishing attacks. That is, I can give some examples for this phishing attacks. So when you see this web page, so as all you can see, like, this is a normal web page, but this is not a normal web page. This is a phishing web page. I will tell how it is. So when you first look at your URL, this is a forged URL. How can I say this is a forged URL? When you see this HTTPS, this is disabled, right? Whereas the other things are enabled. So this is a forged, because that will not be like that. All the things will be, either it will be a bold font or it will not be a normal font. But when you are combining like that, it should be something suspicious, right? Next, when you see here, there are poor grammatical error are there. We are shutting down some Yahoo accounts, and these are all the grammatical errors. And when you read through this, definitely you can just, it's something unfamiliar, so we should not enter into this. Mostly the payable websites only, there will be phishing websites. So when you are going to pay through a authenticated website and not like these type of websites, okay? And moreover, in banks, when you see that, the bank may ask your name, maybe your account number, your date of birth, that's it. But see here, they are asking some other informations like social security number, home phone number. What is the necessity of this? So when the details are more and more, definitely this is not going to be a trustable website. Clear? So we have to be looking into careful. Whenever there is something unfamiliar, please come out of that website and you will be protected from it. Okay. And this website, I can say, this PayPal, you can see two times the PayPal is there. Yes. So that's why whenever you're going through that URL, please read the URL once or twice, and then you can easily see whether it is a trustable or untrustable website. Next, protection of kids from internet. So kids, in the sense, definitely you will be having your brothers and sisters at home, right? So you are coming to the college only from 9th standard. The schools are open. Yeah, maybe your mother and father both are working, they are going out. So you are giving your laptop or mobile phones to your sister or brother, and everyone is out of the home and they are in. So we can just, as a computer science student, you can install, you can save your brothers and sisters from these type of phishing attacks by installing NetNanny, TokoMail. There are many things, but these are trustable things like NetNanny and TokoMail, so that we can get track of what type of web pages they are getting into in when we are going into the home, right? And they will not be unnecessarily prone to any untrustable websites or some other things they cannot able to watch. So this one thing is more important. And next is ATM hacking. This is, you may have in, I think so, every week, at least one news in the newspaper will be like ATM hacking will be there. Like in this Vadapalani ATM machine, this amount is stolen. So how it is stolen? By using the magnetic strip 4-pin number. So we have to be very careful, because what happens is they will be keeping the camera attached in the bottom of the corner of the machine so that it can be easily trapped. Okay, so that we have to be very careful. Next is your best security practices. So these are all the things we saw, like phishing, etc. These are all the things. So how we can secure from these types of attacks? So as I told you, first is your antivirus. Please, those students, I request you, even if you are not installed so far, please install an antivirus software. Even your computer science students, definitely you would have installed. Please teach to other branches of students and your neighbors, and even your father or mother will be using a laptop but they wouldn't have installed. So tell them how important in the sense how secure it is to use all that. Okay, next, whether you are using your firewall. And one more thing I want to say, like password change. Or password vandu 2 years ku munadi vechirpom adhe password we will be keep on using for the throughout 2 years. That is not a best practice, right? So at least monthly once you should change your password if you are using credit card in your laptop. Credit card information or any like these type of information where your transaction is going on, please change your password at least once. So make it a sense, like either 31st or 25th of every month I'm going to change my password, 20th of every month I'm going to change my password, and that password should not be your name. So what to easily remember, we'll be keeping our date of birth or our name or parent name, brother name, sister name, no. So you all know very well, it should be a combination of capital letters, special characters, numbers for a strong password. Okay, all the backups, we are like all the security measures, even though all the security measures are done, there is a statement called expect the unexpected, right? I want to tell once again, expect the unexpected. Whenever we are using our laptops, whenever we are in the online, the data can be lost. We cannot tell, I am very careful how the data is lost. You cannot go and ask the computer. It's after all a machine, right? So as a human, what we have to do, we have to be very careful. How we have to be very careful? Please back up your data. When you're doing a project, madam, some students will come and tell, madam, I have done for so long time. Even the teachers would have seen the student is working very hard. But at the last minute, madam, everything is gone, madam. Right? So that's what I told, expect the unexpected throughout your life, not only today or tomorrow, throughout your life, expect the unexpected. Please take a backup of data using some hard disk. Hard disk costs around 400 or 500, right? Not more than that. So take a backup of data at least every weekend, like Saturday or Friday, so that your work will not be wasted, right? Okay. And there is some concept like BitLocker, that is to encrypt data on your computer. It is also one of the facility you can make avail of the facility. Next is secure your mobile phones with antivirus. As I told you already, everyone will be having antivirus in your laptop or desktop and not in your mobile phones. So if you have Wi-Fi at home, use WPA security and 14 character password. Okay. If you are going to sell your laptop. So I am going to buy a new laptop and I'm going to sell my old laptop. Don't just give as it is. Okay. I have deleted. Okay, fine. Everything is gone. No. So what you have to do? There is something called software eraser. There is an app called software eraser where it permanently deletes all the files in your device. Okay, because something may be in your backup that you might not have noticed, and you might have given something to some other unnoticeable person you would have sell because he's giving so much of money. Okay, I have deleted and I am giving. No, don't look like that. Properly erase all the information and then you can give. Next is regular security audits. Yes, whether like every month I can say like all the data are protected correctly, all the folders are there. I am opening the folder and I am seeing any like any file is affected by virus. You will be having a symbol and it will be showing whether it is affected by virus and everything is perfect. You should have a regular security audit. Next is never underestimate human risk. This is what I told. Madam, this is my very close friend, but he deleted my data. That's what I'm telling. Human risks are more prone. So don't ever trust anyone for your data. Okay, because you are the only sole person responsible for data and no other person is responsible. If you are going to lose your data, nobody is going to come. Okay, I will come and give your data. No, no one is going to tell. So you have to be very careful and don't underestimate your anyone who is near you. Okay, and one more thing is don't share your password with others. So I am not able to access. So I am out of station or something. I'm not having my device. I'm just calling my friend. See, this is my password. This is my mail ID. Please try to get the details. No, don't do like that. Okay, and never leave your devices unattended. I already told you, if you need to leave your computer, phone or tablet for any length of time, no matter how short, lock it up so that no one is going to use that. Next is always be careful when clicking on attachments or links in email. So when you have installed your antivirus security, definitely when you are opening a file, it will automatically ask scanning for virus security. Okay, so you no need to bother about that. But without that, if you do cancel and just download it, then no one can help. So take some time. Okay, just it is going to take a minute or just off a minute or 1 minute, not more than that. So while downloading any attachment, because the attachment is sent by some other person, we don't know whether it is virus free or not. So check for the virus and then you start downloading. Okay. And one more thing, as I told you, double check the URL of the website the link takes you to. Okay. That's what I told, because most of the phishing website, what we have seen as an example, the phishing websites have a forged URL. We can see it is repeated or something is very unfamiliar. So you have to be very careful in that. Okay. A sensitive browsing for banking or shopping information. So when you are doing browsing for some games or something, okay, no need to worry about that. When you're going to do transaction, even if it is 100 rupees or 200 rupees, I'm not going to do a 50,000 transaction, 60,000 transaction. No, hacker needs just your account number and your CVV. He doesn't need whether how much you are going to do shopping. So whatever be the amount, we have to be very sensitive and we have to see whether the network is trustable. Okay. And be aware of what you plug into your computer. So I want a data. I'm not having it. My friend is having a pen drive. Okay. Give the pen drive. I'll just install it and give it to you. At that time, in your mind, what will be there? The data must be entered into my system. That's it. I don't know. I don't worry whether it is virus-free data or something, a phishing data. Okay, so what I'm just doing, I'm just plugging in the pen drive and just downloading and then giving it. So if it is a virus, if it is prone to virus, so what will happen? The whole system is going to be crashed with that single file. Okay, so be aware of what you plug into your computer. Next is watch what you are sharing on social networks. So this is most important, I can say, like now the students are very familiar in Instagram. Wherever they go, the Instagram will follow. Wherever they go, the Facebook will follow. So there is not necessary, even in this pandemic period, no one knows whether they are in, no one knows whether they are inside the house or outside the house, but every of the people, those who are known or unknown, every people will be in the thing like they know what they are doing in the morning, where they have traveled, what they have eat, what they today I cooked something, and they are going to project everything. So what is the necessity of projecting in this cyber attacked world? Unless or otherwise, if you want to project something to your family friends, you create a group, WhatsApp group to your family friends, say your brother, your sister, or your grandmother, like that. You create a small group that is going to be maximum 5 to 10 members, not more than that. and you can chat to them so that, madam, my father is, my grandmother is long back ago, he is very far away, so I want to send him something. Create a group and send. Don't post it in Facebook or don't post it in where the public can see this. Okay, so that is the main thing for the youngsters I need to tell. Okay, so wherever you go, you think like nothing is going to follow me, but everything is followed. See, even in your camera, okay, when the system is on, but you're not switching on the camera, it can be your face and what are all the things you are doing can be accessed by the actor. So the best practice tip, what I can say is, you're having a small cellophane tape, like cellophane tape. So even I have, in my laptop, I have a cellophane tape. When I am using my video for these type of educational purposes, I'll be removing that. After that, I will just put a cellophane tape. That is going to cost a rupee or two. That's it, right? So paste the cellophane tape when it is not needed. If it is needed, you can remove the cellophane tape. If it is, if you are going to do for your classes or something else, you can remove it. That is one of the best practice you can do. Because even when you are not switching on your camera, it can be, the camera can be accessed. There are tools and the hackers have some softwares for that. Okay. It can be very scary, but it's all happening. So when you go to Tesco, there is a shop in UK. You can see that all the laptops, whatever they are billing, they will be having a cellophane tape. So I inquired them, only after that I started using, I inquired them, why do you have a cellophane tape here? And they told like this, okay, then only I started reading that. Then I thought like, okay, this is a simple tip. Everyone will be having a cellophane tape at home. Why not we just cut it and stick it in that? Nothing is going to cost us, right? Instead of exposing everything to some other person, whom we are not aware of. Okay. Offline, be wary of social engineering where someone attempts to gain information from you through manipulation. If someone calls or emails you asking for sensitive information, it's okay to say no. So somebody, this telecallers, they'll be having a very sweet voice, mainly girls, I can say. They'll be having very sweet voice, and when they are calling and they know, they will be calling you only seeing your date of birth. So they will be telling, like, they'll be speaking in a very pleasing voice. So what is your account number? So can you send your account number so that we can send the information? No, please say no. Okay. So try to say no to the person who is asking personal information. Clear with that? So try to say no. No is very good when you are, instead of giving your personal information to someone who don't know you, okay? So you can always call the company directly to verify credentials before giving out any information. So implementation. So implementation, I can say, so if a single person, a single student or a teacher may be having three devices. So three devices in the sense, one is your mobile phone, one is your laptop, and somebody may be having a desktop at home. So average, I can say, one individual has two devices. So if 50% of people are there, we are using 100% of devices. So definitely the data is going to be easily stolen, right? When more and more devices we are using, data security is very less. So we have to be more careful. So that's why I told, I have antivirus in my laptop, but I don't have antivirus in my desktop. Please no, because you are using, when you are using both the devices, you should, the antivirus must be installed in both the things. Clear? So how the technology helps in these types of, I will be just completing within 10 minutes because madam told to complete within 45 to 50 minutes. So I will be just completing within 5 minutes. Technology, how it is important to giving organization and individuals the computer security tools needed to protect themselves from cyber attacks. So what are the three main entities must be protected? First is your computers, next is your routers, next is your networks, and next is your cloud. Okay. So when you are using Wi-Fi also, when someone, a neighbor is coming to you and asking a Wi-Fi password, don't give your password. You give something like WPA password or something else. Okay. Create a new password for the neighbors or some other persons who are entering into your house. So why information security important? So far we have just seen what is data, what is information, and how the information is being stolen by hackers, and what are the types of hackers, and how we can prevent from these type of hacking. So these are all the things we have seen so far, right? So in today's connected world, everyone benefits from advanced cyber defense programs. So as an individual, an information security attack can result in everything from identity theft, which we have seen before, to extortion attempts, to the loss of important data like family photos. So as I told, everything is exposed. When everything is exposed, definitely it is going, even when you, okay, I have posted in Instagram now, but later I have deleted it. You might have deleted from your device, but it is saved in cloud. It is not going to be deleted permanently. It is permanently saved in cloud. So whenever you post something, be very careful, because even if you delete, it is saved in cloud. It cannot be deleted, right? Okay. So what are the common mistakes? Software update. So software update, when it is asking, it will be automatically asking, because that particular software person needs, when you are updating it, he will be having some points. So when the scroll comes, you updation of software, you just click yes, without seeing from which website, from which it is given, no. Okay, next is unnecessary services. Unless or otherwise, if the app is important to you, you download it. Otherwise, please don't download any unnecessary services in your device. Password storage. Somebody will be having a Word document. They will be taking a Word document. They will be taking, okay, for this Gmeet, I'm storing this password. For this Gmail, I'm having 4 to 5 mail IDs. So for this mail ID, this is my password, this is my mail ID. No, then what is the use of password, right? If somebody steals your system or hacks your software, everything is going to be let it down. So don't store your password anywhere else. That's what I told. If at all you want to write it in a diary or write it in a Word document, use the encoded technique. Okay. And inappropriate locations, as I already told, don't use your devices in inappropriate location, and default credential. The biggest risk you face is your staff. That is in this thing, in this line, what I want to say is, எப்பவுமே வந்து வீட்டில் திருடுறவங்க என்ன பண்ணுவாங்க, உங்களை பற்றி ரொம்ப தெரிஞ்சவங்க தான் திருட வருவாங்க இல்லையா, பக்கத்தில் இருக்கிறவங்க. ஹூ கீப்ஸ் ஆன் நோட்டிங் யூ ஃபார் லாங் டைம், லைக் த தீஃப் வில் நாட் என்டர் சடன்லி டு யுவர் ஹவுஸ். வாட் யூ வில் டூ, யூ வில் ஜஸ்ட் மேக் அ நோட் வேர் வென் யூ ஆர் கோயிங், அட் வாட் டைம் யூ ஆர் லீவிங் அவுட், வாட் டைம் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் இன்சைட், ஹவு மச் டைம் யுவர் ஹவுஸ் இஸ் லாக், எவ்ரி திங், ஆல் த இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் வில் பி கேதர்ட் அண்ட் தென் ஒன்லி. த சேம் வே these informations will be misused only by the known people to you. So you have to be very careful with them. Okay, the classification of cyber crimes, we can say the theft of credit card, bank fraud, fake stock shares, these are all the classify, we can classify the cyber crime. And computer oriented cyber crime, yes, the viruses, trojan, cyber terrorism, child pornography, violent and extreme pornography, these are all computer oriented. So in the cyber crime kaga, there is an act. I'm not going to explain about the act. There is an act called IT Act 2000, where all the cyber related activities are prompt to this. So you will be committed to punishment. Okay, for example, digital crime committed by using any digital device is cyber crime. That is a short definition for cyber crime. For example, digital diary, mobiles, pen drives, anything you have unauthenticated information, it is a cyber crime. So yes, IPR. So a small definition and a small, I want to tell you, you all know what is IPR, that is intellectual property rights. Most of the students now, what they are doing, they are writing the article, publishing the article in a journal. So why this IPR comes into? There is something called copyright. So you would have heard, whenever you are going to publish an article in a journal, they will be giving a copyright form. So what is that copyright form? You will be learning that copyright form. This particular article is not published anywhere and it is not given anywhere, right? That means to avoid plagiarism. That means a unique work, the originality of the thing. So that's what this IPR is. Okay. So these are the legal rights that covers the privileges given to individuals who are the owners and inventors of the work. That is, you are the sole owner of whatever you are going to do this. Okay. So suppose why I am letting this inside is, this also comes under the part of cybercrime, because when you are going to use unauthenticated data and you are going to just publish a journal or you are going to publish a book, anything, even if you are going to publish an assignment, it is going to be, you are not having any copyright for just copying and pasting anything. Okay, so this I think you would have known what is industrial design, scientific discoveries, trademarks, service marks. So trademark in the sense the symbol should not be used by any other one. Okay. So these are the types of IPR, geographical indication, for example, Tirunelveli Alva, you can tell, and trademarks is the symbols, and the Patent Act, copyright, these are all the different types of IPR. Okay. And the security measures, authentication, one-time password, program threats, system threats, computer security classification. So these can be included for your security passwords. So just concluding it, what are the main reason for data loss? So I can say like 30% it's due to human error, and 12% due to software corruption, 7% due to computer viruses, 5% is due to theft, 3% by others, and 43% due to hardware failures. Just I have gathered information of what are all, because the data loss is most common nowadays, right? What is the main thing which is there behind the data loss? So these are the things. So we can avoid human errors, we can avoid computer viruses, we can avoid theft, okay? But software corruption and hardware failures, if at all we install a good antivirus software, we cannot do with this. So these are all the data recovery tools. You can use this like Recuva, RStudio. These are all the data recovery techniques you can use. And the process of data recovery is, first you can evaluate, recover, and then for extraction, you can use extraction recovery images. These are the techniques we can use. So to conclude, due to the ever increasing dependence on the internet, because without internet, we can't think about this pandemic and also in the post-pandemic, the biggest challenge we face today is the security of information from miscreants, right? So as the world is increasingly interconnected, everyone shares the responsibility of securing information as told by Newton Lee. So I think, I believe like all the students will be at least practicing. If at all I have told 50 questions, right? 50 tips for you. If you follow at least 5 tips out of that, I think I have made this day. So I once again thank this secretary correspondent, principal, and head of the department, Dr. Kasturibai ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much for your valuable information, ma'am. Now I would like to call Mr. Prem Kumar for a vote of thanks.
Good evening to one and all present here. I consider it a privilege to deliver the vote of thanks on this immense occasion. First of all, I would like to extend my gratitude to our esteemed secretary and correspondent, Dr. M.G. Sellapuram sir, and I would like to thank our honorable chief guest, Dr. R. Deepalakshmi madam, for gracing this occasion with this august presence. My heartfelt thanks goes to our respected principal in charge, Dr. K.C. Lalitha Bigam ma'am, and Vice Principal Professor S. Asitambi sir, and Dr. P.T. Kasturibai, HOD Department of Computer Science, and their team for giving me the great support throughout the webinar. My final thanks goes to our beloved students, without whom this function would not be have been possible. So once again, I thank everyone. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Can I leave, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.